But you have to understand, a fighter was just in a war, 11 rounds. He's had losses in the past. He needs to win. His adrenaline is pumping. And actually, Ricky, the trainer swung first.
Wama pumped first.
You think?
Yeah, Wama came up and he fucking boom.
Yeah.
He didn't catch him good, but he hit, I think, on the chair or something, and the trainer just stepped back and boom. Hit him like twice in one.
So the trainer almost knocked him out.
Yeah, you see that?
He rocked him
out, but stunned his ass.
So if you ever have a fight and your opponent runs over to Ricky after the fight, Ricky, what would you do?
I'll defend my fighter. I'm gonna defend my fighter.
So if Brandon's one man, he just knocked out his opponent. Let's say he just knocked out Victor, right?
Right.
And you run up.
I'm gonna be happy. I'm gonna lift up my fighter.
Okay, in that situation, if he's not, like, say, whatever, and I lose, whatever, so trainer goes after Rob Ricky and hits him, I'm gonna try to get back up and start swinging. Even though I got dropped, I'm gonna get back up, and I'm gonna go to the
next one.
If I get knocked out again.
My question is, let's say you get into it with another trainer. Does Ricky jump in or no? Because Juanma's trainer didn't really jump in. Not really. He just pushed him back, but he didn't like swing at him.
Oh, but maybe the trainer is like, fuck it, man.
Yeah, like, I'm not getting involved with that shit.
Yeah. Shut up, bitch. Fuck you.
Who is that?
I don't know. Fucker. Fuck that fucker. Don't open the door, Ricky. Fuck him.
Yeah.
So Ricky.
I'm not Ricky, fucker.
He went outside. So Brandon, let me ask you this. Victor Ortiz called you out today.
Right.
You're excited. Man, you haven't been this excited in camp since you heard that. Now you're motivated.
I'm not motivated. I'm just happy that the fight got happy. You know,
the fight happened. That the fight will happen.
The fight's gonna happen. No matter what, it will happen. Sometime next year, the fight's gonna happen.
But now,
I'm pumped up because I've been wanting to fight this guy for a long time, but we couldn't because of the fact that he's a promoter. But now I'm free agent and I'm going after that ass. And you can run, but you can't hide no more, homie.
You know when Derek Chisora and David Hay had a press conference, they separated them with a fence. Yeah, I think it's going to be the same thing. You have to put a block between you two, no face-off, because it's going to go on in the press conference before the fight even.
It's going to go down in the deal.
Honestly, Brandon, if you faced off with him today, you would start swinging. He would start swinging. It's not going to...
I think it'd be vice versa with all of us. We hate each other, I think we both start swinging at each other.
Separate press conferences, separate locations.
Yeah. Nah, fuck that. Same press conference, man. Same location, same day, same time. Fuck that. We got you.
So what do you tell Victor Ortiz now that he called you out and he's watching this?
I'm coming.
Like Jaws, the shark?
Like Jaws on me. I'm like Jaws coming for that jaw. Yeah, I'm
telling you. How bad did you want this fight? Because, Brandon, if I'm not mistaken, wherever you go places and fans talk to you about who you want to fight, his name comes up the most.
Not that, but like I said, man, this time I've been really disciplined. I've been in the gym. I've been actually training and not blowing up like I used to. So I'm very excited. I'm happy. You know, I know what I can do. I know what I can do now. When I'm on my best, I'm a threat to anybody. But when I suck, when I fucking lag off.
You lack off all out.
I'm fucking one.
But you know what's crazy? You guys grew up together. You turned pro around the same time in the same camp. He fought Mayweather. You fought Pacquiao. And it's a crazy, it's like a movie. It's like a Hollywood movie.
Yeah, and then like that, because I'm not a movie star. Maybe this motherfucker wants to be a movie star. But
I'm saying the storyline. Like, you can't make it up. You know, sometimes 24/7, like when they used to do it on HBO, they used to exaggerate stories. You don't need to exaggerate, like say, like when I was 9 years old.
His story is exaggeration. He was never up to for adoption. He never got adopted and done like that. His grown up like my grown up. With poor kids. You know what I mean? And he found the easy way out and she went with a lady that her name was Miss Ford. And she wanted me too, but. Why? If my dad was good and everything, I was cool. I love my dad. I love my parents. Why would I need that? I was embarrassed what I didn't have. And he was embarrassed what he didn't have.
Brennan,
that's why he left.
What weight class would this fight happen at?
47. Why?
No, I don't know. I'm asking because...
Why 54? Why 47?
You sparred him in the past?
I used to spar him a long time. When he was growing up as a kid, I used to make his ass cry all the time.
What do you mean make him cry?
In the ring.
With tears?
Yeah, like he used to make him cry.
Like cry as complain or?
Cry like he cried.
Why?
I just fucked his ass up this morning.
I thought he hits hard.
Hits hard. I give credit. Hits hard. But he had no heart. When the cells get boring, you have no heart.
You can't wait.
I can't wait. If the fight's ever happened.
Hey, it sells out. It sells out Staples Center. It sells out the MGM. It sells.
I don't care about the selling part. I don't care about that shit. All I care about. Now we even have the chance to do sell the differences.
Two Mexicans going at it.
Fuck that. I'm gonna fuck with two black guys, two white guys.
No, but I'm saying it's a fan-friendly fight.
I'm just saying. We gotta settle our differences. You know,
in the ring.
This motherfucker saying all kinds of bullshit about me and shit that wasn't true. You get a people after me. And the motherfucker doesn't learn. He doesn't like Kevin Hart said, he doesn't learn today. Alright.
Do you think Top Rank are like shocked now? Like they had you and they could have made this fight and now can they just make Crawford John Molina?
I don't know. I can't tell you bad about Top Rank. All I know is that. Thank them for
for all the good years.
For all the good years they had, you know, they for building me up to almost a superstar.
You are a superstar, Brandon. You're famous.
Almost a superstar. Thanks Top Rank, you know, for promotion. But I think it's time to move on. You gotta go sometimes to the grass on the other side. It might be
beautiful. Okay, crazy question. Should you and Victor Ortiz fight in an MMA cage with MMA rules? 5-minute round and you lock the cage in? You just lock you guys in?
Nah. Boxing. Because I don't know MMA.
No, not MMA punches, but MMA rules where, you know, when you get in the octagon, they lock the octagon.
Yeah. But it can't be MMA rules because I don't know nothing about MMA.
Yeah.
So you gotta be fucking, yeah. MMA, locked the octagon, whatever, like, this man, let us do us.
That's boxing.
Not boxing.
Okay.
Fight everything.
Who would you want on your undercard, Brandon? Because this fight will sell and the whole world will tune in.
I don't know. Honestly, I don't really know.
What, you want Juan Funes on your undercard?
I don't really know, dude. I like that Juan Funes, not like, to be on the card.
But we gotta find him someone that he has beef with.
Yeah. But why don't have beef with nobody? He's too much of a nice guy.
Let's ask Ricky. Ricky!
But honestly, I don't really care about all that bullshit.
You just wanna fight Victor.
That fight happens with you. I think it's gonna happen. That's if I really wanna.
Alright, tell all the fans where to follow you.
You can follow me at on my Facebook page, it's Bam Bam Brandon Rios. Follow me on my Twitter page, Brandon_Rios1. Follow me on my Instagram, Brandon_Rios1. Follow me on my Snapchat, BatmanReels. And you can find out what I'm doing. And now we got some exciting news, so